sure that you've got your mics on.
Good.
And you make sure you speak clearly, because we do have members in this chamber that are finding it very difficult to hear. And also other members that do have to have signing so that they can contribute to the meeting. So please do keep the background noise down. Can we keep yourself nice and clear on the mics? Decorations of interest. Do you have any decorations of interest? No? Okay, moving on to the mayor's announcements. I'm aware, I've been made aware that there is 3 petitions to be handed in. It's not normal that petitions are handed in on an extraordinary council. But because one of them is pertinent to this, what we're debating tonight, I can't take one without the other, so I made a decision to accept all 3 petitions tonight to be handed in. So can I have those petitions handed in, please? Councillor.
Taking the time to come to listen to a debate and be wrong
fair debate is when people are taking the time and trouble to attend.
There's a motion on the floor. Is there any other comments before I take the vote, Tommy?
Against.
35 for, 23 against and 1 abstention. So that motion is carried.
Shame.
Shame.
Right, so moving on to, I need a mover and a second for the amendments, please.
So move, Mr.
Mayor. And a mover and a second for the second amendment.
So move, Mr. Mayor.
Can I hear the second amendment first, please?
Commission.
that seems everyone's choice except for the The Labour members also caused the Conservatives to apologise for wasting council taxpayers' money and in bringing this debate and for politicising the issue. Mr Mayor, the only people who tried to make political gain in this situation were some of the Labour members by laying the blame at the government's door. Mr Mayor, government is not closing Girtrell Court. It is about choices made here in the bill by this Labour administration. Perhaps Mr Mayor, they should shut their scriptwriter. That would save £56,000. Mr Mayor, I will also not take any lessons from Labour using my position to protect the 133 families who use Girtrell Court. I will not apologise for trying to save 45 jobs at Girtrell Court. No. Mr Mayor, I will not apologise for speaking up for some of the most vulnerable people in our society, many of whom are unable to speak for themselves.
Whether it's been breaks town replacements. So Girtrell Court didn't specialise anymore in respite. And for me, people need respite in specialist facilities which offer the right care for the right people at the right time.
And you would know that,
Councillor.
On the 14th of April, there is an event in the Floral Pavilion which will showcase at least 12 different independent providers who can offer a range of services people are asking for. And the event will be open to current users and carers
and the general public,
as well as people who presently receive direct payments. The exhibitors will include shared lives, holiday breaks, and facilities for people to have 24-hour caregivers.
In Devon, in a caravan.
We don't want them coming into our homes.
That would be a choice. We're absolutely aware that there are many people who will need traditional type building-based respite. But this will be provided by the independent sector in a smaller, more specialised unit. And we're talking to a number of providers who are really keen to work with
us. Sure they are. Lots of dots for them.
The more sensational headlines that have been appearing, particularly online and in petitions, say that we are closing respite facilities for people with disabilities, forgetting to add that we are not stopping respite, but we're providing. And I will keep my promise that the respite services will be equal to, or better than, those which people have.
Is that in quantity or quality?
I also promise that friendship groups who receive respite will continue to have the opportunity to have their respite at the same time. The budgetary decision was made in the public arena, as far as I'm concerned, at Budget Council, as required by the Liberal Council. Just to move on quickly to the Liberal amendment, which talks of spokespersons from the Family and Wellbeing Scrutiny Committee being allowed to do some scrutiny. But I understand that Councillor McLaughlin, who is chair of the committee, has already said Councillor Clements has requested it, that they're going to follow certain users through the process and so get that understanding. And I'm very happy to be the spokespersons as we go through the process. I'm very happy to move the amendment, Mr. Mayor.
Says
said, this facility continues and is continuing to offer this service.
Yeah.
Yes.
Until the full examination of all the options, then that might have been different. Well, again, towards the end of the article, it said, and this is, I think, perhaps a killer paragraph, the officers are making the required arrangements to give respite care users their preferred alternative choices and begin the process of transferring our services over. Now, that can be read in various ways, but I read the stable door is shutting and the horse is bolted.
Yeah.
Correct.
Now, I accept
and scrutinise the changes that have been made in our name. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Should be done. Autumn is after August.
Mr. Mayor, please come to the Labour Amendments. say, must have something to hide.